What's up, guys? It's Uncasual TTV, and I'm back with another video. This hair is a little spring look, even though it's cold outside. Hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Stay tuned.
So let's get started.
To make this look last longer, we're going to prime our face. So we're going to use this NYX primer. So, to tame these brows, I'm going to use this spoolie brush to brush all the hairs in line. Lately, I've been using this hair to shade in little spots that I see that's missing here. Alright, so I take this black eyeliner and I'm going to fill in just the tip of my eyebrows. I'm going to use this Fit Me Concealer in a shade 35. I don't know the name of this brush, but it's really good for blending concealer. It has really short bristles. I do the top of my brows off camera. Prime my lid with this Smashbox 24 Hour Primer. I'm going to take this setting powder, Laura Mercier, to set a foundation for my shadow. Alright, if you have oily eyelids, this will help for it to stay in place all day. And we have the ABH palette. I'm going to start with the color Dawn. I'm going to blend just the crease of my lid. Right on top of that, we're going to take Roxy and blend it in. So I went with this e.l.f. palette because I remember the shade that will look really good over this color. Back into this palette, we're going to use All Star for the corners. I'll do it for you, that's real.
Back into this e.l.f. palette, we're going to choose this shade to cover the lid. Be sure to keep blending it out. I'm going to take this color from the e.l.f. palette and this other color from ABH. Now I just love this small thing because it has so much pigment in it. This is from Victoria's Secret. So I'm just gonna pop that in the corner of my eye. Shout out to me trying this. I've never did it before. And I don't know. I'm not sure if I see a difference. Tell me if you guys see a difference in the comments. So I'm just going to put a little bit of this Maybelline mascara on my eyelashes so that it will kind of blend in when I put on my falsies. There's still so much eyeshadow on my eyelashes. Now I didn't put that much on it because I wanted to be able to dry quick. I just wanted to add color back into my lashes. Now I did this under eye makeup before I did my concealer, and I probably should have waited until I did it afterwards because it made it kind of hard for me to blend my concealer when I applied it. So I grabbed my wet beauty blender and we're going to start. So I'm going to do my foundation. This is my favorite foundation. I haven't found anything yet that fits me like this one. So I'm going to do my face. And two pumps I did. Now I did this so every area can get makeup. Wetting your beauty blender will make it easier for you to blend. Just do it in a patting motion. This will help for it to blend easy. This is LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Cool Tan. I I tried not to bring it up too far because I really should have waited to do my under eye. Now I'm not going to highlight my forehead because that seems like the blonde hair already brings out my forehead. Now off camera, I used a brush to bring it up a little bit higher underneath my eye. This is another LA Girl concealer in the color Chestnut. Now this line didn't even come out straight on my nose, but when I blended it, you can't even tell. The line going across your nose gives it like a small little button look. Now I got real fancy. I brought the concealer down all the way to my neck and it brings it out a lot. It gives a slimmer effect to it, even though my neck probably doesn't really need it, but I know some people might want to see it. I'm going to take this Black Opal finishing powder and I'm going to start baking on my face. Now if you shake some out in the top, it will be easier for you to dip with your beauty blender. Now I took the flat side because it will be easier to move along my face. The difference between this powder and the Laura Mercier powder is this one is a little closer to my complexion. Alright, now let's get into this contour. Let's start blending it. Let me get something to blend it. Now, this is a brush by Sonia Kashuk. I believe I'm saying it correct. This brush, it's really good. It's kind of like a kabuki brush. It blends out really well. I found this brush with a lot others at Target. It was on sale. I start by blending, bringing the makeup upward towards my cheekbone. Now I let this sit on my nose and melt into my skin long enough. Let's blend it. So the line across the nose just rounds out your nose. So now I'm going to go in and try to touch up on my concealer. Now to brush off this finishing powder. Okay, so one of my faves, this CoverGirl, I'm gonna use some of this and put this on my cheeks. Now we're gonna wrap this look up and we're gonna do these lips. Alright, so I'm trying to decide out of all these colors what is going to bring out this eyeshadow. It kind of takes me a while, but I found it. So I decided to use this Revlon lip pencil, and what do you know? It's broke. It fell out. But I do have another color just like it from Revlon, so this is gonna work. So I fill in my lips. So here's a little trick. This is like a reddish brownish color, and I'm going to make my lips look more fuller. Now this pretty Wet n Wild coral color, I found it at Walgreens. This color is so pretty and it blends really well. Doesn't give you a sticky feel at all. Okay, Fenty Beauty. We're gonna use Hustler Baby, like always. I decided to mix the both of them, and it came out pretty bright. I realized that the both of them together, it doesn't get as shiny as it would normally. I grabbed this Anastasia brush. It's dual-headed. I added just a subtle little look to my eyebrow bone. Urban Decay finishing spray. We are going to spray just 6 inches away from our face and let it dry. And this completes our look. And this is the finishing look. This is a DIY shirt I did. I got it from Old Navy. I hope you guys enjoyed this look as much as I did. Alright now y'all, don't miss the upload. Turn on your notifications. Just touch the bell.